Have you ever thought about becoming a manager one day? In this video, I will share with you 5 surprising learnings I got from being an engineering manager and give you some recommendations for how to think about people management as a career path. Lesson number 1, management is not a promotion. I have to admit that early on in my career, I had always assumed that becoming a manager is a significant step up in your career. But after I successfully transitioned into a management role, I learned that's not quite the case. Let me show you what it actually looks like. When we join software companies as a fresh graduate, we typically start at level 3. Now, don't even get me started on why it doesn't start with level 0. The system is clearly not designed by software engineers. As you become more experienced, more proactive, and more independent, you will get promoted to L4, which is sometimes called a mid-level engineer. And then you start to learn to solve more complex and ambiguous problems and delegate work to others, which gradually turns you into an L5. And that means you are now a senior software engineer. This is where an interesting thing happens. In many companies, you would now have the option to either keep advancing your career as an individual contributor or to transition into a people manager if there is such an opportunity. It's worth noting that some companies discourage L5s from this transition and instead would require engineers to first get to L6 before they are allowed to explore the role of a people manager. But that's not a consistent practice everywhere. You should always discuss with your manager to know what the path looks like for you if you are interested in exploring. The reason I said switching to management is not a promotion is precisely illustrated here. In most cases, it's a horizontal move that does not give you a pay raise. In big tech companies that have a mature career system, when L5 engineers switch into management, they become M0. With the exact same pay. Likewise, M0s can decide to switch back to the IC track and become an L5 again. There is also the possibility for people to move to management track in a diagonal line, but it's harder and typically takes longer as well. The transition does take a lot of time and energy because you need to first learn a different skill set to get yourself ready for the job. This can take anywhere from a few months to 2 years, depending on how quickly you pick up the skills required. If you spent the same amount of time advancing on the IC track, you could have made significant progress or even made it to L6 already, which is an actual promotion and does come with a significant pay raise from L5. See the difference? Promotion, not a promotion. This is not to say that the transition into management is a waste of your time, but if your primary motivation for the switch is to level up in your career, you might want to rethink. In fact, people who think of the management job as inherently more superior than ICs often have other wrong assumptions about the job as well, which leads us to lesson number 2. You work for your team, not the other way around. Because the job title says engineering manager, it gives many people the wrong impression that the role is all about managing your engineers as a set of resources to work for you and help you achieve your objectives. This misinterpretation created a lot of bad managers. To understand what engineering managers really do, we need to first talk about teams. Every team is a group of people who share a common mission. This mission can be a big one, such as sending humans to Mars, or a more specific one, such as building a microservice that supports a part of your company's product. This mission belongs to the team, not the manager. Everyone on the team, including the manager and everyone that reports to the manager, is doing something to help achieve that mission. They are all partners that share the same mission, and they each take on a different set of responsibilities. That's what makes them a team. The manager's job is to help the rest of the team maximize their chance to succeed in that mission. And there are a lot of different things that could be standing in the way. If someone on the team is getting blocked and can't make progress, it's the manager's job to help them remove that roadblock. If an engineer is not happy about what they are working on, it's the manager's job to understand that root cause and make necessary changes to improve the situation. If people on the team aren't operating efficiently because of bad processes, it's the manager's job to identify the opportunity and drive optimizations. The manager works for the team, not the other way around. Someone needs to play this support role and help maximize others' impact. Managers who recognize this often achieve stronger success and become a multiplier to their team's impact. Managers who don't understand this responsibility will leave that support role unfilled. People on their team will not be getting the help they need, and as a result, the team works inefficiently and can't produce strong success towards their mission. Now on to the next lesson. You can be a leader without being a manager. When I talked with people who are exploring the management career path, I often asked why. And when I heard about their motivations, it's quite clear that many people envision themselves as a leader, not a manager. They wanted to have a strong influence on a large group of people to build something big together. They wanted to define the vision, strategy, and roadmap for their team. They wanted to be the one that represents their team in public settings. Although sometimes the manager of the team is the one that plays those roles, that's not always the case. More often than not, it's PMs and tech leads that have more opportunities to do those things. The reason we often see managers playing a prominent role in their team's direction is twofold. One, the manager needs to maximize the team's chance of success, so they do need to get involved to make sure the team has a good direction. Two, the manager is often the most senior person of the team. Hence, they have a lot of experience to contribute. However, good managers are always looking for opportunities for people on their team to step up and become a leader, because that's how their team overall can achieve more. So if you are an individual contributor and you would like to become a leader on your team, management is not the only path. You just need to have a career discussion with your manager and figure out how to acquire or demonstrate the required skills before you lean into the role. It's also worth noting that no one can make you a leader. Your manager's support is necessary but not sufficient. You need to build trust with people around you, create clarity, inspire confidence, and add value to their success. As a result, people start to depend on you more and more, and that's what turns you into a leader. I will make a future video to talk more about leadership skills. Please remember to subscribe if you don't want to miss it. I seem to have talked about many reasons you don't want to be a manager. Now, how about we switch gears and list a few reasons why you should consider the transition? Lesson number 4. Being a manager helps you become a better IC. Many people couldn't make a decision of whether they wanted to be a manager or not. It's very normal because you simply don't know what it feels like until you actually try it out. You might worry that if you spent a lot of efforts on the transition and ended up deciding to switch back to be an IC, you would have wasted valuable time. I can tell you that's not the case because I did exactly that. I spent a few years being an engineering manager and I enjoyed many aspects of the job. However, I still decided that I prefer being an IC in the current phase of my career, so I switched back. Did I waste a few years of my career? Absolutely not. The experience helped me learn a lot of soft skills such as indirect influence, conflict resolution, crucial conversations, managing up, and the list goes on and on. I would not have been exposed to so many opportunities to practice those skills if I remained an IC. And now I find these skills so valuable because they help me become an effective senior IC that can handle a lot of very difficult situations that many other ICs can't. So, regardless of what you ended up deciding for yourself, I encourage you to explore the management path if you think you have the right motivations to play a support role for your team. At the very minimum, you will learn a lot and benefit from that experience. Besides the learnings, I also found the experience very rewarding, which takes us to the last lesson I will share today. It's a song of ice and fire. People management is a job that can be stressful, yet rewarding at the same time. In a lot of ways, it's similar to being a parent. The stress comes from having a lot of people whose success depends on you. And you know that there's always something more you can do to help them. The job can never be done, unlike code completing your project. This creates a non-stop mental pressure that you will need to learn to manage. It also comes from the expectation that you need to maximize your team's success. That means every problem that hinders the team's success is your problem by default. The tech lead just got sick and your team doesn't know what to do? That's a problem you need to solve. One of the engineers doesn't like the PM? That's your problem too. At any given moment in time, you can always see a long list of problems like that, and you can never solve them all. You need to learn to live with imperfection to prevent yourself from losing your mind. On the other hand, there are incredibly rewarding moments in a manager's career that you don't get to experience as an IC. You recruited young engineers to your team and started to help them settle in. You see them commit their first code change, and you say good job. You see them cause their first incident, and encourage them to learn and try again. You tell them about their well-deserved promotions, and see their excited yet nervous look. And one day you wake up to realize that some of them have become leaders in their domains. They are solving extremely hard problems for the company, and they started coaching other engineers with what you told them. Those are the moments when you know it's all worth it. These are the 5 lessons I've learned from being a manager. If you find this video helpful, please help click the like button so more people can benefit from it. See you next time.